Hey, everybody, it's the Coats. This is Madden Football on EA Sports. On tap, we've got what should be a fairly intriguing matchup between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Houston Texans. With that, let's head over to the space city of Houston. Standing by at NRG Stadium, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The scene from a few moments ago, this crowd enthusiastically cheering on their Texans as they emerge from the locker room. And we're just about ready for football as the Texans get set to match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Brandon Godden, Charles Davis, happy to be with you. And Charles, we've got two teams who know each other extremely well. These division games, they tend to be battles.
People scout like crazy in this league, but no one scouts more than within the division. Because if you win your division, you're automatically in the playoffs. That puts extra emphasis on these games, and they can't wait to get at each other.
And we are underway from NRG Stadium in Houston. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the Jags. They'll be led out by Gardner Minshew, sixth-round selection in 2019 out of Washington State. He'll be brought down about the 28. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. They'll try the right side here with Fournette. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. The defensive crew for the Texans. Here's a look.
Versatile players on defense are all the rage in the NFL, but it also helps to have a Benardrick McKinney who does one thing very, very well, and that's tackle ball carriers. Big man. Big size inside, looks like a defensive end playing inside linebacker, still has the ability to run and cut runners off before they can get downfield.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. Off play action, it's Minshew. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A pickup of 27, and they pick up the first down in the process. They were in zone defensively, went with a crossing route. It's always interesting to watch that chess match.
Yeah, and I think safeties don't mind crossing routes against zone because eventually you're going to run into their territory, and that's when they lick their chops in order to get the big hit or a play on the ball.
Offensively, nice execution to find a hole, make the catch. So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 46. Now Leonard Fournette. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. On the run, it's Fournette. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive.
Here we go. 60 outlaw.
Minshew, first and 10. Into the hands of his tight end, Jeff Swain. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A big one there for the Jags. 18 yards, first down.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a gain in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that open things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it.
Throwing on first down is Minshew. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack.
Boom.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. A quick throw complete to Chark. And oh, he's gonna be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is gonna get him a first down. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's gonna be 15 yards.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal.
Let's make these babies run.
Minshew sets to throw, and it's caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the one-yard line. A gain of 7 that time, second goal.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal?
Three down.
Here's Minshew. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. DJ Chark, the intended target, but now it's third and goal.
Now we've got third and goal coming up, and couldn't you imagine being in that huddle, partner? You know they're looking at each other saying, we can't come away with just 3 points after this drive.
Yeah, they've covered a lot of ground. They want more than that three. Now Minshew toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So they opted to pass for it on third and goal. Let's see what they do on fourth and goal.
Well, I think they threw it with the idea that if they didn't get it, they would go for it on fourth and goal. So they've got another play in their pocket. They're going to have to call it right now. No field goal here.
So on fourth down, Jags kicker Josh Lambeau comes on. Less than an extra point attempt here. This is an 18-yarder. And he'll try and throw here on the fake. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And on the opening drive of the ball game, the defense comes up with a goal line stand.
I know coaches always tell us that they make decisions about these types of plays, this type of a fake, earlier in the week to take the emotion out of the deal. I don't know that that was really true here. This one felt like all of a sudden, hey, I have a feeling about it. Let's go ahead and get it, and it just didn't work.
Yeah, I know one thing. They wish they had it back.
Yeah, they certainly do, but the buck stops with the head coach on that one. He has to greenlight that attempt.
A give, the first man through, Gillespie of the fullback. And he's able to get this across the 10 before being taken down. A pickup of 11 at a Texans first down.
I know a lot of times we like to put players in certain boxes. He does this and he does that. But this guy, he can do a little bit of everything. He's not just a lead blocker or a guy who protects the passer. Handing the ball, he might want to get out of the way.
Out from the shadows of their goal line, here's first and 10 from the 11. On the ground, this is Lamar Miller. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Play action for Miller. Now Watson. Pressure gets to him, and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line, Calais Campbell. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. They can create points using their defense, and this time they take their man down.
After the sack, they'll come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And indeed, that's what they'll do as they run it here. And they'll mark him down right around the 9, just shy of the 10. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to fourth down. Well, they did go run, so you were right. Maybe a little more breathing room for fourth down.
Well, no one wants to be accused of playing it safe, right? But instead, they would just reverse it and say, we're playing it smart.
Here's Brian Anger now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Yards on the return that time, and the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. Starting field position for the Jaguars offense as they come up first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. Well, starting drive number 2 off on the right foot. Completion for the first down. Drive 1 is they had to be pretty frustrating because they moved the football. They just didn't get any points out of it.
But warm-up QB 2, let's bring in the backup. I mean, my goodness, you take them downfield and you don't score points. You know I'm being totally facetious here, right? I'm just kidding. Nice first drive. Rarely do teams score on every single drive in a game, but they like what they did there. They just hope they can pay it off this time with some points.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll go play action here with Minshew. And this one into the hands of DJ Shark. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely, great start. 2 nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that?
Break. 41 Mike. Check right, check right.
Hey, we've got tight left. One tight end, one tight end.
Five.
From the gun, Minshew to throw. This is caught. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. From 8 yards out, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
How about that touchdown, partner? If you blinked, you probably missed it. I looked away for just a second, and they were in the end zone.
Josh Lambeau now for the point after. And this is up and good. The score now 7-0 Jaguars. So they only needed three plays on that drive. And it results in a touchdown for Jacksonville. The touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And he's going to have the hook up to QT. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And it'll be second and 12.
And that was well defended. And as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Watson now to throw. And an alley to run. He's going to take off with it. A nice job of eluding the pressure there, scrambling for 11.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
And the Jags with five in the secondary now on third down.
Let's get that ball here. Let's get that ball right here.
He's got Fuller. Slips past him.
Where'd he go?
So much for the run on third and one. Instead, it's a big chunk in the pass game. First down.
When you call a wide receiver screen, no matter how many blockers you get in front of the guy that catches the ball, there's still an aspect of the guy catching it, turning into a runner, breaking tackles, and creating his own yardage, and he just did on that play.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 34. Watson with a give to Miller. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Good opening quarter for him. Remember, he had the sack earlier. Now a tackle for loss, another tackle for loss.
He's really making it tough on the play caller, though, isn't he? Because it's one thing to try and adjust when a guy is disrupting your running game. But when he's messing up your passing game as well, they may have to devote at least a second guy to him to try and keep him away from their plays.
They're not ready for this, man. They're not
not ready for this. They still playing.
On second and 12, Watson sliding out of the pocket. And an alley to run. And they'll get eight out of this before being stopped at the 28. From the gun on third, Watson, and that is incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well, and he didn't get that done on that play.
So on fourth down, Texan kicker Kyemi Fairbairn comes on. And this will be a 45-yard attempt. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So that's a seven-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
And things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to the goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
Fairbairn now following the made field goal. He'll send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Set, ready, 8-3.
Let's go, D. Big series right here. We got to step it up.
Now Minshew on first and 10. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he had been able to haul that one in.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. The Texans come at him and able to bring him to the ground. The sack there by J.J. Watt.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
And the Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on third down.
You got three down.
On play action, they'll throw. And able to find Conley. And a nice gain of 21 yards. This quarterback now 7 of 10 here in this first half, and he's got a first and 10. Now Fournette. And an alley to run. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 16 yards that time on the pickup for the Jags and a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit, thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Ready.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. That one complete. He finds Shark. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards, the final tally.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory as they've got it to the 28-yard line. They'll run with Fournette. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
And they'll try the jet sweep here. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
Anytime the offense shows what they call a shot play or a chunk play where they're trying to get big yardage, sometimes people just call it gadget plays, and you hold it to a gain that we just saw there, you feel pretty good about yourself as a defense.
Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Looking to throw it. Minshew. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
It's about how teams are so competitively mashing. You just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on 3rd down. On is Josh Lambeau now for the Jaguar field goal. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get 3 of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue because, you know, after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get 3? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
Field goal back out. Lambeau to kick this one off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Watson will bring up the Texans here, 1st and 10 at their own 27. And now the throw going to Fuller, and he's got it. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 15 yards, the Texans pick up the 1st down. Him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. On the jet sweep, here comes Fuller. The tackle will be credited to Jake Ryan.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
46, 19. You must be getting tired of seeing me.
To throw on second and six. Watson, open man, the tight end fails. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. And the Jags have five in the secondary here on third down. A shotgun snap for Watson. And the throw there going to be incomplete. Here's Brian Anger now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. This is away and a very good kick, angled for the sidelines. This one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. And the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now, it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time, able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. So a much rosier picture now after that last play. Here's first and 10 at the 19-yard line. Fournette. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Second and 13, Minshew, the strong safety, Jahlil Adai right there in coverage.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point, get your head around, locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
The Jaguars on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is going to be third and 13. He'll look to throw. Dumps it off to Fournette. And that's not going to get it done. He'll come up well short of the first at about the 21.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. DeAndre Carter is deep for the Texans. Good open field tackling there. A 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. Getting set to go again, DeAndre Hopkins marches back onto the field. You better believe that he's well aware he has zero catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware as well, and they're really excited that he has no catches, but they're also worried because a lot of times that's like the ticking time bomb. The longer you hold him down, when he finally explodes, look out.
Yeah, no catches, though, so far in this game. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start out on the ground. It's Lamar Miller. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. It was Taven Bryan who got him down defensively.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Watson going to give this one to Miller. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Watson. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he takes us up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down.
All right, let's just go ahead and walk through this one pretty easily, right? Blast off the line of scrimmage, get downfield to a certain point, usually around 8 to 10 yards, turn around and make sure the quarterback sees your numbers and set yourself up for the pass.
A well-executed curl route by Charles Davis. Now a first down throw, Watson, toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. To throw once more on second and 10. Watson with a catch made by Hopkins. And he'll get this way down into Jacksonville territory. The Clemson connection. Watson to Hopkins for a big one. 42 yards.
And that might be exactly where they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. To the air yet again, Watson. And he'll find Akins there, complete. And able to get this down inside the 15 to either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right, got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. It's complete to Hopkins. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4.
Let's go, let's go, let's
Third catch for him on this drive alone, and it'll give him a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Watson looks to throw again.
eluding the...
And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags. And I believe this is going to be a first down.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal.
Let's go, let's bring it. Let's go.
Again, it's Watson. And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. Kiki QT there to make the grab, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and we are even at 10 apiece. So that one, an eight-play drive. It spans 75 yards. And the result, a Houston touchdown. Now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and three, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks, because then the defense has the advantage.
You talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. This is Fournette, and he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Ten logo.
On second down, here's Fournette. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division, every year, is trying to make sure they draft people charged with trying to block J.J. Watt. So far, hasn't been too successful.
The Jaguars on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 7. Off play action, it's Minshew. Caught here by Conley. 11 yards there for Jacksonville, and a first down as well. So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 43. Throwing on first down is Minshew. And he'll get that to Fournette complete. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Ten yards there, good enough for a Jags first down.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Going with Armstead, a first down carry. He'll get about six there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
The last run got six, now second and four. On second down, Minshew. The open man is Westbrook. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 14.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
This quarterback now 12 of 16 thus far. It's first and 10. Here's Minshew. That's to his running back, Leonard Fournette. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it's a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. They go back to the ground now with Fournette. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three.
Here we go. Here
and they got 3 yards. That's enough. A conversion, and now it's first and goal.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay? I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the darn ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, third and short. That's what you're supposed to do. Like you said, old school smash mouth football. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Now Minshew. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
Quick pass to the outside, caught by Conley. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the 4-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
They come out here in the eye. Line of scrimmage at the four. Here's third and goal. Here's Fournette. And he'll take this one in for a Jags touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Jaguars have taken the lead. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating what we have to make the call. They already had it lined up. Never even got to it.
Lambeau to add on the extra point. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17 to 10. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told, and it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. Touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. DeAndre Hopkins and the rest of the offense heading back onto the field. He's been good so far to this point in the second quarter. Need to get him even more involved, maybe?
I would agree with that. Definitely. Yeah, it's not even a question for me. The way he's playing, he's doing a nice job. Increase things. More touches, more opportunities. Maybe that can reverse things on the scoreboard for them.
They'll try to ratchet things up then maybe here in the second quarter. Watson will bring up the Texans here first and 10 at their own 24. Now it's Watson, a bootleg. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught.
Let's go.
An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. A shotgun handoff now to Miller. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Now on second and 13. Watson, he's got his tight end. It's Fells. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
The Texans on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 7. Play action from Miller. Now Watson. Got an open man. It's QT. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the marker. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Here's Brian Anger now, as he's on to punt for Houston. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds.
Let's go old Nice goal there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
2 yards, good enough for a first.
At the 16-yard line. A loss of two there. Second down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
That coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis in his first half of action. A pass there, complete to Westbrook, and down he'll go at the 25. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it, because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
The Texans here on third down putting an extra defender in the secondary. They'll try to throw for it with Minshew. That's out to his running back, Fournette. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
On the set. So first and 10 now from the 30. He's scared. 41 Mike. 41 Mike. Now Minshew on first and 10. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Nothing at all on that one. It'll be second down. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. The completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. On the draw, this is Fournette. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. So a good run by Fournette. Now another first and 10. Minshew, first and 10. And this one into the hands of DJ Shark.
And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Fournette, a first down carry. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And they double him up here. That makes our score 20-10. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with 3.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal. Not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
Now after the main field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'd love to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Fielded about a yard deep. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Out comes a Houston offense as they get set to take over here. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
try and get things kick-started for them. And you know, at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
They'll run with Miller, and they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
What's the old expression? 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
And now the throw going to Fuller, and he's got it. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
On 1st and 10, Watson. He's got Fuller. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. Off of play action, it's Watson. That complete to Lamar Miller. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. First down carry now for Miller. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A pickup of 11 at a Texans first down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10.
Silver.
A shotgun snap for Watson. And a catch made by Hopkins. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Watson. It's complete to Fuller, and he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
They'll run on 1st down. Miller. And able to work his way down to the 16. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
From the 16, Watson throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Will Fuller was the intended target, and it's 3rd and short.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback, but when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Here's Watson, open man, the tight end fouls. And they'll lose yardage here, knocked back to the 19-yard line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that's going to make it 4th down.
No surprise they decided to throw on 3rd down. a little bit of a surprise that they completed the pass and lost yardage on the play.
So out comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. Fairbairn able to put this one through. And that will tighten this one up a bit. Now a one-score game at 20-13. So a decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged three out of it, but they inch a bit closer.
Yeah, but still lots of time to go in this one. That's why you hear that clapping on the sidelines, right? Hey, got some points. As you said, inching their way back in. Time left to go out and get that victory.
Fairbairn now following the made field goal. He'll send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll be brought down at the 23. Make it the 24-yard line. Here he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. Hey, he's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time they were able to churn some clock, they got the field goal, added onto their lead. But that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt.
And we'll both be headed to the airport after the game, but we probably should go to the post-game press conference because someone's going to ask the head coach about this drive, and he's going to profess that he was happy to get points.
But
and we know
it?
That's not true.
Yeah.
Okay, after this type of a drive, not getting a touchdown, a huge disappointment.
He's coming. Double up, double up. He's coming, double up. Ready?
And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Only two there on the dump off. It's third down.
A 2-yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
Let's go now. 8 reads.
I got you. I got you.
Minshew sets to throw. And that will be incomplete.
And I think the end result, knocking the ball away, was a product of understanding where they were on the field, understanding how many yards they needed to pick up the first down, and tightening their coverage accordingly. Gave them no gaps, no spaces, no real air in which to catch the football and end up making a really nice play.
Here's Logan Cook now as he'll punt it away for the second time. A big rush by the Texans and they block it. It's picked up and this is a live ball, remember. And this will be a touchdown as his guys are in for six as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game.
Partners, you well know every block punt wasn't necessarily a called block. Sometimes the guy just finds his way back there. Doesn't matter. The play happens, and that one turned into 6 points because they handled it so well after the block.
On for the PAT, Kaimi Fairbairn. And that will tie our game here in the third quarter. Well, not only did they block it, the awareness to go and grab it and then take it into the end zone for 6 points. For what's been a tight ball game, we're all even at 20 now as the kick's away. This is taken at the 3. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Jags offense now gets set and heads back onto the field. Play action here with Minshew. That one complete. He finds Sharp. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend there?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let him know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
Fournette, and he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
On the ready. So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. They go jet sweep here with Chark. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's no gain on the play, and they'll remain a few inches shy of a first with third down looming.
Come on, set, 50, plant.
Looking to throw it, Minshew, and tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete. There defensively to knock it away was the safety, Justin Reed.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Here's Logan Cook now. Remember, though, he did have one blocked earlier. And this one goes angling out of bounds, and it will be spotted inside the 30-yard line. And now out comes Houston. So first and 10 now from the 30. They begin with a run by Miller. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 15 yards, the Texans pick up the first down.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. It's complete to Hopkins. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. The 20, 10, touchdown, Houston. Jordan Akins, 55 yards, as his guys are able to regain the lead.
I think the key to that play was them understanding and knowing that once the ball was out, they were still eligible to pick it up and carry it.
Yeah, there was some standing and some staring on the wrong side of the football there, wasn't there?
Yes, he has a name, he has a number, but for us, he's Johnny on the spot. And how about that rambling run all the way to the end zone with that alert play that he just made?
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And they will take a 7-point lead. The long touchdown pass gets him 6 on a very, very tidy 2-play drive that time. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent, just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged. Mm-hmm. How big a mistake and when it occurs. No interceptions so far. They'll like that.
No! I just want you to know that you agreeing with me, that's going to get me through this third and fourth quarter. Are you touched? He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
Respect.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
They always say that real estate is about location. Well, guess what? When it's a slant route, the quick ones, timing, timing, timing. Got to be able to lead your man with the football.
And the timing off right there, threw it behind him. From the 21, it's second and 10. Step. On second and 10, it's Minshew. Open is Swain, the tight end. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
And they're left looking at third and 8 after the second down pass play only went for 2. Minshew throwing on third down. Into the hands of his tight end, Jeff Swain. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
Here's Logan Cook now as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. He juked him. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Texans are going to have the football with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. Getting set to go again, DeAndre Hopkins marches back onto the field. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 14-yard line. 10th carry now for Lamar Miller. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4.
Get in the weight room. Get in the weight room.
They'll run it again with Miller. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
On first down, it's Miller. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. 2nd down.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
They'll try the air now with Watson rolling to his right. And he's going to keep it here. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for 3rd.
The tackle made by Miles Jack. That's a gain of 7. Brings up 3rd and 3.
47, 18, 24. I got one.
Play action from Miller. Now Watson. Blitz coming, and down he goes. These strong safeties, some people may not realize it. It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in him on that play emerged.
Here's Brian Anger now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. How do you break down his game so far? Just the one touchdown pass, but sometimes the touchdown pass stat category, that doesn't tell the whole story.
It really doesn't, not until you balance it with the error side. You know, and in this case, he hasn't thrown any interceptions. So a lot of people would call this almost a pedestrian game, kind of a bus driver game. But that's just really wrong. Being a bus driver is a good thing if you're running a football team, because that means you're in control and you're taking your team to the right places.
Yeah, he's been pretty solid. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Justin Reed, the safety, made the tackle.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on 2nd down.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Off play action, it's Minshew. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. So 3rd and long, here's Minshew. And he's going to be brought down. Back back at his own 6-yard line. Whitney Merciless showing no mercy, flies in for the sack.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness of that defensive line is eating them alive.
Here's Logan Cook now as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. A good kick, 49 yards, just 3 on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. Deshaun Watson of the Texans offense trot back out there. And the stats on the screen tell the story. A great start. This defense, they've made some good adjustments, though. He's fallen off since.
Have to like what they did at the half, but you also have to like the fact that they hung in there. Despite the fact they had a tough first half, he was locked in, right? Rocking and rolling. They came out, made their adjustments, got their confidence back. Now they're causing him all sorts of trouble.
They'll run on first down. Miller. And he's going to take this across midfield into Jacksonville territory. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Again, it's Miller. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
It's going to be a long day. It's going to be a long day.
Faking the give. Now Watson. He finds his target, Fuller. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. Gonna do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Inside the 10, and finally taken down at the 4-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. To throw is Watson. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. The linebacker, Miles Jack, able to knock that one away.
But there's no trace of nervousness there. He was able to diagnose that play from his linebacker position, stay in excellent coverage, and bat the ball away.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. Now Watson, He'll buy some time right. He'll run it. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
Stop short of the goal line. A gain of 3 yards. It's now third and goal.
They come out here in the eye. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. They'll run it. Here's Hyde. And Hyde will not get there as they force him to the ground shy of the marker. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So that's a big one. Obviously, Charles makes it a two-score game. His third field goal of the game, able to knock it through.
Yeah, not exactly free and clear yet, but as a defense, you get to play a little bit looser, don't you? Because you do now have a little bit of a margin of error, don't you?
Fairbairn now following the made field goal. He'll send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Ready up.
Now Minshew on first and 10. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Well, there's times when you see these catches that are made, and we just know the guys playing it are really wishing for college rules. Only need that one foot down instead of two. Yeah, it's awfully difficult on the sideline, isn't it?
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now Minshew. The open man is Westbrook, and he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Here's Minshew. And he'll get that to Fournette, complete. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Jacksonville first down on a pickup of 17.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks. And they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together?
Ready, break.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 44-yard line. Throwing on first down is Minshew. He's going to air one out, and that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Whitney Merciless able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Remember, throughout my career here in defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. But they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. And some secondary help here for the defense and the nickel on third and long. They'll set up a throw, and this is going to be incomplete. Great coverage there all around. Really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
Here's Logan Cook now as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And a look now at Lamar Miller. And in the early going, the running game, as we see the numbers, it just wasn't on point. Well, now it's gotten more true to form.
And sometimes it takes a little while for an offensive line to get in sync, because early in a game, defenses throw different patterns at you, different formations, different sets. And you might not block them quite the way you want to, but as you start to get into a groove and you figure out what they're doing, now it all comes together, and that's what we're seeing right now.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point,
the kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe-bash.
That. Super
from the 36, Watson, and he's going to drop this off to his fullback. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down,
and they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position, but as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean that's a fullback playing in that spot.
Well, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college with all the spread offenses, not very many pro style, where you actually have a true fullback. We're having to make do in the NFL and put guys in that spot who emulate it but aren't necessarily that position.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
He's got his tight end. It's Fells. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 down at the 33. Now it's Watson, a bootleg. They'll roll him out right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there, because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Miller will get it. He has been busy today. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Now play number seven of this drive, but it's a tough third and nine. A shotgun snap for Watson. And that is incomplete.
They don't want it, folks. They don't want it. Keep playing.
Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is it allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. And he didn't get it there. No, it's no good. Just shy of the crossbar, and this score will stay right where it is. Now, Charles, all things considered, I guess that's not a critical miss at this stage, is it?
No, but still everything helps when you're trying to finish off a ball game. And you're right, not critical in terms of the scoreboard and the team. But the guy with the golden foot, he knows he's only as good as his last kick.
And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with him punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Minshew, first and 10. He's got it over the middle to Jeff Swain. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
You got to give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Minshew sets to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. He's going to take off with it. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive gain.
Check 41. I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
They'll go play action here with Minshew. Open man is Westbrook, complete. A really good pickup of 28 yards. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Come on, so set. Signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
Lee Griffin, Lee Griffin.
And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Throwing on second down now, Minshew. That's to his running back, Leonard Fournette. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it'll be third and 10 now. Looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Out of the gun is Minshew. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
They went with the dime look that time on defense. Just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And Lambeau will put this one through, and the drive will wind up yielding three. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three and out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
Now after the made field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. This fielded at the two. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple of extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 27. Here's Watson, and he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Here's Watson. Out to his left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Sacked by Yannick Ngakoue, the former Maryland Terp. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sack. Quarterback gets hit.
Throwing on third down, Watson. They'll find Miller. That's complete. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
Here's Brian Anger now as he's on for the fifth time here today. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the eight, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. Shoot to throw. Open is Swain, the tight end. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pick up there, 26 yards. What a throw right there for the first down. He has taken some real punishment in this game, but still standing in the pocket completing that one.
He's a flat-out warrior. There's no question about that. How about him stepping up into the teeth of the rush and delivering there for that big strike and that big pickup?
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Fournette running out of the gun and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville and a first down.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 42-yard line. Now whistles here, and I believe one of the Jaguar linemen might have moved. The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
A false start backs him up five, first and 15. Looking to throw it, Minshew. He'll set up the screen to Fournette. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Call it a gain of 12, but of course not a first down due to the previous penalty.
When you run a screen pass really well, you gotta like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
To throw again on second down, Minshew caught here by Conley. And he's gonna be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 18.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw into the hands of his tight end, Jeff Swain. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. They go jet sweep here with Chark, and that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. 41's got it, 41's got it. He's back to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down.
Watch the pass. Ready?
On fourth down, Minshew. The open man is Shark. It's complete. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. So they've gone for it twice now on fourth down of this game, and both times unsuccessful.
I wish we could hear the headsets now between the head coach and the offensive coordinator. Now that they're 0 for 2, if they get into a third situation, head coach might say, hey, you got anything for this one? Might get radio silence back.
And now out comes Houston. And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all three timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are. Jordan Thomas. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They're not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. A give running right, it's high. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. Again, it's high. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. Texans look to let the clock roll.
It's a loss of a yard. Brings up second and 11 at the 45-yard line.
We're set. 19.
Run 56. The rush, rush, rush.
Down to a knee goes Watson, and that should just about do it for this ball game.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So Houston going to come away here with the victory. And you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
An absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. Well, what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just a week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it, tuck it away because danger lurks everywhere you turn.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Texans as we say so long from Houston.